him,
snatch him,
hold him,
scold him,
pounce him, trounce him,
kick him up and bounce him. Before we take a lens off, I'm so curious as to ask his name.
Thank you.
shortage of bread?
You better shut up about my mother.
Don't be rude, workhouse. I bet your mother was a regular low down low life.
What did you say?
It's a good thing she died last year. You should have it. She would be sent to prison.
Thank you. intimate acquaintance. Very glad to see you, Oliver. Aren't we, my dears?
Yeah!
Yeah, of course we are, baby.
Leave me alone. Dodger, take off the sausages. Charlie, lay the table for Mr. Craig.
Back off, back off. Back off.
One at a time, make careful. Would you like that, my boy?
Yes.
train?
Mate, what it's what I love!
Shh! Of course, no charge, no charge. Just do everything that Dodger and the other do. Making new models. Especially Dodge. He's been right over back.
He's going to say something to play.
You meet him tomorrow. Now, is it possible, per chance, that my handkerchief is protruding from my pocket?
Yes, Mr. Fagin, I can just see the edge.
Really? I'll see if you can take it out by moving it, like you told the others do.
Never tire of it, leave you there. Flowers, no feathers, cry, 'cause the fern be low.
Oh.
Thank you.
Two-Face Boys. B-Face Boys. Mealy-Face Boys.
And which is Oliver?
Mealy, where did he come from?
Didn't I tell you?
He was arrested for stealing Mr. Brownlow's pocket handkerchief.
What?
It was all my mistake, and when the shopkeeper told us what really happened, I brought him back here to make what amends I could. I must confess, I found myself strangely attached to the child.
He's deceiving you both. He stole your pocket handkerchief, didn't he? Then he'll steal it again.
But he didn't. Thank you. Now, Alison, wait a moment.
Oh dear, did you particularly want those books to go back today?
Yes, I did.
Send Oliver with them and be sure to deliver them safely.
If he does, I'll eat my head.
Yes, please do.
Yeah. Very well, my boy, very well. I want you to take these books and say you've come to pay £4 that Mrs. Brownlow owes. Here's £5. I shall expect you back in 10 minutes.
Very well.
In a new set of clothes, with expensive books and a £5 note in his hand. If he comes back, I'll eat my head. With my head.
Who will buy my sweet red roses? What do the blooms go round? things.
Miss Brownlife!
He's nothing but a thief and a vagabond. Come on home, young man.
Come on, young man.
Thank you. comes when I'm 70. Must come time, 70. When you're old and it's cold, and nobody cares if you live or you die. You want consolations to money you may have put by. I'm reviewing the situation.
Of the Dunstable Workhouse and arrange for them to come for a meeting today.
The governess is here to see you.
Thank you, Rose. Show them in. Good morning, ladies.
Good morning, Mrs. Brown. The incident received your letter regarding dear Lady Oliver. I decided to bring the first coach to London.
I decided?
It was good of you to come. Do you have any information for me?
This locket, ma'am, once belonged to the boy's mother. Mrs. Bumble found it after she passed away. The boy's mother is not Mrs. Bumble.
And have you kept this all these years?
Well, why wouldn't I?
Didn't you even think this could provide an answer to the boy's identity, his name?
But the boy had no name. The boy's mother was unmarried.
It was your duty to pass this locket on to a higher authority. Your behaviour was shameful.
How dare you speak to me like that? I only came here to help you.
You only came here to claim your reward. Think yourself lucky I'm not handing you over to the police. Rose, show these people out.
Well, that's gratitude for you.
I hope, Mum, that this incident won't deprive you of my office.
I hope Madame is that it will.
But it was all Mrs. Bumble. I had nothing to do with it.
That's no excuse. Now please leave.
Murder if they knew I'd been here.
Murder? But where is Oliver? Where is Mrs. Higgins?
I can't tell you.
Oliver is perhaps my nephew, and if you tell them what you just told me, if you tell the Bar Street Runners what you just told me, they'll see that you come to no harm.
I must go back. You see, back there's a man I just can't leave. You see, I love him. You don't know what it's like to love someone like that.
I understand.
Do excuse me, but I'm anxious about Oliver. How can you help me?
I'll bring him to you. Not here, that's too dangerous. Do you promise I won't be watched or followed?
I promise you solemnly.
Then tonight, when the clock strikes 12, I'll meet on the London Bridge, and I'll bring Oliver.
Move! Move!
Help! Think about it.